Well, some big retailers and restaurants, they are taking heat for opening on this holiday, but many of them are striking back, claiming that workers volunteered for Thanksgiving duty. And with earnings down, is the holiday shopping season the last chance for these businesses to turn it around? Let's ask Ed Butowsky, managing partner at Chapwood Investments. Happy Thanksgiving to you.
Same to you.
So the first, let's talk about those workers, like
sure.
Jamie, myself, you, who volunteered to come in.
Right.
You know, what are workers saying, and how do they really feel about working the holidays?
Yeah, and I'll tell you, it's interesting because, you know, I went around after hearing more about this, and most people are really thrilled. In fact, a lot of people wanted to do it because they're getting paid, you know, not only time and time and a half, but some people that I've talked to are actually getting a vacation day for doing so, and other bonuses. They're getting bonus cards. So I think there's a lot being, you know, talked about on this for no reason at all. A lot of people are excited about getting a little extra paid during this time.
What about meeting their bottom lines? I mean, is this a case where companies have to open up? You know, they have to kind of keep up with the Joneses to meet their bottom lines or exceed them?
Well, they do. I mean, this is a very important retail season, and a lot of these companies, it's kind of a make it or break it for a lot. You know, we've heard about that year after year since the liquidity crisis. I will tell you, this year, it is really tough for these retailers, and they're going to have to make a real strong decision right after the holiday season. So their bottom line number, you know, they're not coming in great. And Heather, this is going to, you're going to see this everywhere. You'll see businesses, unfortunately, fold come January and February because of the rising costs for them to do business. I mean, their costs are soaring all the time between taxes and keeping up with regulations, insurance costs, and obviously this Obamacare is sort of like this negative thing that's going through the bloodstream of all retailers today because of how much it costs them to, you know, not only their employee costs, but also their health care costs. This year will be the year we'll see more retailers go out of business, unfortunately, January and February than we have in many years.
Well, that's not good news.
No,
but,
it's not.
You know, also every year we hear people complain about it and they say, you know, these businesses, they shouldn't open on Thanksgiving and it should all be about the family, stay home and give thanks, which we should definitely all give thanks.
Absolutely.
But does that really affect those businesses and the ones that delay opening? We talked about some of those earlier today, Costco being one of them. When they delay opening until Friday and they actually have a Black Friday instead of a Gray Thursday, do they benefit in any way by doing that?
Well, look, this is the thing. When Macy's announced that they were going to open up earlier, all the competition had to do so as well, or a lot of them did, because a lot of people do go shopping. But on the big scale, it's not a big thing, okay? Most of the shopping is not going to be done just on one day. Just like myself, I'm going to see my family. I'm not going shopping today, but I guarantee my wife and my family, we're going to make up for it on Friday. So opening up today, I don't think is really going to help the numbers, but some people need to get those early sales, and they need to get, you know, traffic coming into their store. So it might help a little bit, but it's not going to be a real significant number at all.
All right, so we don't know what's going to happen this year, but we can compare it to last year. Last year, about 35 million Americans, they showed up on Thanksgiving Day to go shopping. That was a 21% increase from the year prior, 2011. Yeah. You expect those numbers to go up again this year?
Well, yes. I think more people have more money in their pockets, okay? So I don't think there's any question that people are going to go shopping. I don't know if it's going to go up that much because those percentages are off of lower numbers. So I can't tell you that it's going to go up higher, and I don't know how strong those numbers are anyway. What I do know is a lot more is going to be done online, which also puts pressure on those retailers. Let's not forget that. So there's going to see a lot of purchases being done. I think it's called Cyber Monday.
Yes.
So we're going to see a lot more buying, you know, online, which is also going to put pressure on retailers. Retailers have a bullseye on their head right now, and it's tough and it's unfortunate because, you know, I love these small businesses. I love going to small little towns and finding great, you know, deals and going to a lot of these great companies. And it's a very tough place to be in business these
days. Well, you know, you mentioned Cyber Monday, but speaking of small businesses, there's Small Business Saturday that happens now as well to get people out there. Mm-hmm. And we just had the small business mandate, you know, being able to sign up for healthcare online. That was delayed. Those businesses just got that news yesterday. A lot of them saying that that was a huge insult. So really imperative for them on Saturday to get shoppers out.
It's imperative throughout the whole time. And when I go shopping, I don't necessarily focus in on the small retailers, but I do know a lot of them in our hometown. And I want them to do well. I want everyone to do well. It's going to be a tough year, I will tell you that. Shopping might go up Cyber Monday for sure. No question about it. People are very comfortable shopping online these days. So a lot of people are going to get a lot of good gifts, but it is tougher for these companies.
All right. We will see what happens. Ed Butowsky, happy Thanksgiving to you, and thank you for joining
us. To you and Jamie.
Thank you, Ed. Mm-hmm.